Show. I'm Titan Isaiah from the Smite community team. And if you're new here and this is your first time kind of checking this out, this is our monthly update show, our show where we break down everything that's headed your way over the next few weeks coming to Smite. We're going to be going over balance changes, buffs and nerfs to gods and characters depending on pro and casual play and your feedback. We've got a lot of awesome skins, some community news about some events, and of course, the reveal of our awesome new crossover battle pass, TMNT, aka Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. I'm super stoked to hop into it. And with me, you know, I've got the squad ready in the background from the design team. I've got Pon Pon and Clumsy. First of all, how are you guys doing today?
Yeah, I'm doing pretty well.
Hey, it's going good. Good day.
Nice. Well, we have got a packed show today, guys. So let's go ahead and hop right into it. And we're going to kick things off with bonus balance for 7.10, the Trickster God update that is headed everybody's way next week on the 20th. And before we hop all the way in and do a deep dive, we're getting towards the end of the season and the World Championship. Mm-hmm. So our balance philosophy is changing just a little bit. Pon and Clumsy, you guys want to talk about what's going on for these last two updates of the season and how we're addressing balance moving towards the World Championships?
Mm-hmm. Definitely. So yeah, the big thing is, depending on who you are, you might notice the year has either flown by very quickly or has been stagnant. But we are approaching the end of the year. We're approaching season 7. Happening shortly. And so with Worlds happening soon, we need to make sure that we focus on
Impact,
this
no
balance
guidelines.
Change being the main bulk of our
just some gameplay, some
like
shit
pro
happening.
High level focus changes. I'm targeting things that are very currently in the top of the meta, things that we know the pros have been talking about.
So that's a lot of the focus of
this bonus balance and this patch as a whole. With this one being the bulk of it, with next one only really being there for fixes.
But
we don't want to shake
like
up
his,
the things
yeah,
too,
in 10 years.
Or too close to the actual world itself.
For sure. So lots of sweeping changes for this bonus balance round in the November update. And once we move into December, it's going to be just some smaller tweaks and fixes as we get closer to the World Championships. But let's go ahead and talk about bonus balance, guys. We'll kick it off with items. And first off, we're going to talk about Heartseeker getting a nerf here. We're going to be decreasing the bonus damage from 3.3% to 6% down to 2%
again?
To 5% of the target's max health.
Yeah, Pon, you want to go ahead and start on this one?
Yeah, sure. So one thing that we noticed, we see a lot of people discussing, especially around like tank survivability and the like average lethality that damage dealers have against tanks and vice versa. One thing that we saw actually bear out pretty well in the stats is that assassins especially are killing tanks more effectively. Hunters and guardians, their relationship's a bit more complicated, but assassins do seem to be overperforming in that regard, and Heartseeker is a big reason for that. So we are reducing the percentage on that to better deal with assassins killing tanks too easily with Heartseeker. So a small reduction on the max health hit should bring them more in line and just kind of set a good even playing field for all the roles.
For sure. All right, next up, we've got Serrated Edge seeing a nerf here. This one's pretty basic. We're just going to be decreasing the movement speed from 10% to 7%.
Yeah, that's fine.
Serrated Edge is one of those items. You know, we came in, we did several different tweaks towards, and around the same time, we also lowered the movement speed across many different items, and Serrated Edge kind of came in with a lot of movement speed on it. So we're going to just bring it back in line to kind of those other items and do a little bit to the movement speed on that one.
All right, let's move right on to Gods for bonus balance. And the Trickster God update, we're going to be seeing a Loki buff in bonus balance. So first off, Agonizing Visions, we're going to be increasing the physical power scaling. And then Flurry Strikes, we're going to be increasing the damage scaling on that ability across all the hits. Pon, I'll let you take it away here.
Damn, okay.
Yeah, so Loki, scaling buff? Obviously rework happened. People have been playing him a ton. A lot less frustration when fighting him, which is the goal. And looking at how things have kind of shaken out with people playing him, people learning the new style of play, we expect him to perform a bit better over time as people kind of adjust to this new ability playstyle, but we do see that he is underperforming more than we'd want him to, and specifically people are trying to figure out where they want to put him and looking at more towards the solo lane. So we wanted to bring up his assassin capabilities. So 2 scaling increases, a 5% on the ticks of Agonizing Visions, as well as a 50% total increase on the 5 initial strikes of Flurry Strikes to make it a bit more lethal in the late game. And most importantly, each strike of those 5 strikes will now apply a 15% slow that refreshes. So it won't stack, but it will refresh, giving you a little
hybrid.
Bit of ability to chase and slow down targets and keep them in that flurry.
Still going
to
be hybrid.
So helping him out in
be
most of the
hybrid
two big
too.
Complaints were he felt like his damage fell off late game if he went scaling, as well as having a hard time actually keeping people in flurry strikes to get to the final hit.
All right. Well, let's move right along here. And I'll preface this. These aren't in alphabetical order, but there's definitely a method to the madness here. We're going to kind of split things up by role here for this bonus balance section. Like, let's start off with solo lane. Mm-hmm. And let's talk about Sun Wukong. Going to be getting a nerf to Somersault Cloud. We're going to be decreasing the physical power scaling by 20% there.
Yeah, so as we mentioned at the beginning, a lot of this is going to be catered towards, you know, the high-level players, SPL, and the Worlds coming up soon. And if you were paying attention to the SPL, Sun Wukong is, you know, he's there. He is in the solo lane. You're seeing him so very much right now. And we know that a lot of casual players enjoy playing Sun Wukong as well. We wanted to just find something that was a little bit, you know, too strong on him, and we were getting a lot of feedback from the pros as well. And I think we can all agree, ultimate dealing, you know, 120% damage when you're building as a Bruiser in Sun Wukong, it's a little bit high. So bring it to 100, I think it should be pretty okay for Sun Wukong.
All right, let's move on to Amaterasu, going to be getting a nerf here to Dazzling Offensive. We're going to be increasing the cooldown. It's 75 seconds at all ranks now. It's going to change to 95, scaling down to 75.
Hmm? So this is another one. People have probably been seeing us nerf Amaterasu and feel like we've probably gone a little bit too far on the nerfs. But this is something that we see at pro level play, especially Amaterasu is a very contentious pick.
Like,
so we're focusing on the ultimate cooldown here. This mostly matters at like level 5 through like 15, where you can reliably ult before your enemies are going to get their ultimate up. This just brings her more into line with other characters while still preserving her late game strength. We think this is very targeted at the high level play, and most players who play her in like more mid level games are going to feel like she's still like a strong character.
Definitely. All right, let's talk about Hunters next up. Cupid going to be first up for bonus balance nerfs. Heart Bomb going to be decreasing the power scaling from 90 to 80%.
Okay. Yeah, so we gave Cupid a little bit like a little bit of love in that minion clear department, and with that, he is skyrocketed. I mean, he was always honestly a good pick, whether you believe it or not, but he's the number one hunter across the game right now, in take ban as well as in win rate. So you see him all the time in the SPL too. He's one of the highest hunters in contention. So we're going to be hitting that power scaling a little bit, because it hits pretty hard. 90 on two different hits, that's 180 power scaling. We're going to bump that down just a little bit on each hit.
All right, next up for Hunters, we've got Rom, those the top two we always see contested. Astral Barrage, we're going to be decreasing the base damage on the ability.
What?
Yeah, Rom is another character that has been basically at the top of the Hunter
pool.
So
they hit Astral Barrage?
We're just focusing on taking some of the high-end damage off Astral Barrage. We've seen a lot of teams really secure fights after the fact with this ability, even on just the initial hits. So decreasing the base damage here will just make it more likely that enemy teams survive. You have to actually land all the shots versus just maybe the first two to really secure a kill. Small nerf, just again, to take the edge off before Worlds hits.
They really don't want that.
All right, moving on to the mid lane. We got Hera up next. Divine Shroud, we're going to be decreasing the health on the shield. 20 Hera's level down to 15 times Hera's level.
Yeah, again, talking about the higher competitive level, there's a lot of different mid lane strats going on, from the ADC mages and that meta to Hunters coming in. And then we slowly started seeing some mages coming in. And with those mages that came in was Hera. We started seeing a lot of Hera. And we know her damage potential can be pretty high, but she also lacks a movement ability of herself outside of her shroud. And we think one really important way to take her down a notch is bringing down her survivability, especially towards the late game. So that's where we're targeting for her shield.
They're actually hitting all the right
guys. Yeah, when you have CDR going, you can just pop that shield all the time.
Sure, definitely. Yeah. All right. Next up for mages, Habois, the god with four ultimates. Water cannon, we're going to be decreasing the damage. And then Atlas of the Yellow River, we're going to be decreasing the slow and the movement speed buff on the water carpet.
Yeah, so Hebo here is definitely a character that we've seen also come in. Just the raw amount of power that he brings, like the mid lane into the jungle role, are just really, really high. So taking some of the base damage off Water Cannon to slow down his early game fight capability. And Alice of the Yellow River is a 40% to 80% swing now, down from a 50 to 100% swing. Still a good ability, still definitely really strong, but not as strong as it has been.
For sure. All right, last up for bonus balance, we're going to talk about the support role. Kuzumbo up first. We're going to be on Sumo Slam, decreasing the damage on the ability.
Oh, come on, man.
Yeah, I mean, Kuzumbo, especially in the early game, right? People are starting to pick up Blink. People are starting to use that turn radius, which we gave him a little bit ago. It's really great strength. And we're seeing a lot of damage being dealt, especially once you hit one god into other minions as well. So we're specifically catering towards the early game for Kuzumbo, because we're pretty happy with him in
the game. The new skin turtles, not the OG turtles.
All right, last up for bonus balance, Hercules is going to be seeing a nerf here. Strength of Pain, and we're going to be decreasing the base physical power from 5 plus 1 per level down to 2 plus 1 per level per stack.
Oh my god.
So this really targets his like early, especially like 1 to 5, where he's really threatening. If you get plucked by him, if you get pushed by him, if you just try a basic attack trade with him, you're going to lose.
That's
to the Hercules.
A lot of power.
Taking some of the base amount of power off this will just make it so that when you fight him in those early stages, if he's playing either solo or support, it's not the
early, like, it sounds like not a lot, but that's
right
all
now.
Like, just
still strong,
any
not
taking
strong.
Away any of his auto attack, like, fucking, I'm all gonna right, slap
well, that
you
wraps
down
up for bonus balance heading you guys' way next week. We got some awesome skins headed your way next week as well, so let's go ahead and talk about them. First up, we've got an all new chest headed your way called the Aquatic Revenge chest, and the skin that's going to be featured in that chest is Fenrir Fenrir, and this is definitely a new take. He's the king of the deep. And as we get card art coming up here in just a second, you guys will see what I'm talking about. What do you guys think about this shark?
Card art, sick.
I was expecting something way more cute for Fenrir.
I know.
I mean, I'm a big fan of this one. I remember seeing the concepts for this one a very long time ago, and I was very excited to see this one come into the game. And looking at the card art, it looks exceptional.
Yeah,
yeah, the metal jaw is just too cool.
I know. We'll be able to see some of the details as we go in-game and see the turnaround here. Get a little bit of a closer look at the model. And I'm definitely loving all the different details. That metal jaw is crazy. I
just
love
like,
the pseudo-armor
you got there. The maws, just the teeth and everything. Oh my gosh.
Clumsy's loud.
I know, right?
I'm really glad sharks can't actually walk on land.
I know. That would be actually terrifying. Let's go ahead and take a listen to the voice pack for Fenrir Fenrir.
From the dark depths to the battlefield, I'm an apex predator.
Yeah, he is definitely terrifying. Mm-hmm. Headed you guys' way next week in the Aquatic Revenge
chest. The jaw makes that all skin
cool. Funpocalypse Dodgy coming to the Funpocalypse chest. Ooh. And this is a fun theme that we've been doing for a long time. But Dodgy, actually the first assassin and the first goddess to get a skin in this theme. So this is definitely one of my favorites. And as we get ready to get the card art showing up, Clumsy, what do you think about this?
Fuck.
I mean, immediately I'm drawn to that helmet, right? With like the eyelashes.
All right, that's
the
fucking
mascara.
Sick.
That's, I hope
it looks good
cool.
in game. Please, claws, please don't be one of the ones with the great card art and the shitty in game.
Man, I know, right? The world where this like occurs is spooky.
I know, right? You've got like, first of all, you've got like Hachiman and all those hunters.
Okay, they made it look pretty good.
Crazy assassin. I don't know whether this is cute or terrifying. It's so creepy.
It's a little bit of both, right? That's kind of the sweet spot.
Yeah, fucking.
I know, right? She is definitely ready
see
to bring
one
the madness.
Pops.
Let's go ahead and take a listen to the voice pack for Funpocalypse.
We're not
going to
see that shit, are we? It's not that crazy.
Nothing
but it's
a
good.
Few notches of mayhem can't fix.
Definitely ready for the mayhem and the madness. This is definitely going to be one of my favorites come next week. But we've got the Odyssey Reckoning going on, our premier end of the year event with an awesome tier 5 at the very end of it. We've got some awesome skins that we're coming out with next week.
Wait, another tier 5?
Well.
Is that what they just
we'll
said?
Started off with Oni Guardian Ares, and I'm definitely loving the aesthetic on this one. You've got the Japanese vibes and the card art.
Oh,
on.
That's sick. The shield is
oh
dumb.
Yeah, this one. I remember seeing this in like a playtest. I was like, oh my god, this is too cool. Like, this is like, I think, one of the coolest things we've done for Ares.
This is an awesome Ares. What the fuck? Ares has some good skins,
dude. This
too.
Is super dope. I'm loving like the, awesome. The demon / yokai Japanese vibes. And as we see the turnaround here, all the details on the armor. I'm loving the bead necklace. This one looks fantastic.
That literally looks like the card art.
That's
doesn't look like that. That is
I know,
sick.
Right? The singular eye. He only needs one
he
eye on his
big.
Head. He's got two
thick,
eyes
dude.
On the shield.
That's a
definitely
big boy.
Ready to come at you. And let's go ahead and take a listen to the voice pack for this one.
Temple edict dictates that my sword fights for the highest bidder. Let's take that gold.
There we go. He is definitely ready to carry out the mission, get that gold, and he's going to be terrorizing the duo lane. I can't wait to see that one in action. Next up, we've got Raxolotl Ratatoskr. So if you guys remember, we actually did a community vote because we wanted you guys' opinion on what cute animal we wanted to turn Ratatoskr in. Raxolotl 1, Otter was a close second, I have to say, but I'm super excited for Raxolotl Ratatoskr. Definitely the community came up and was ready for this one. And look at this one, it's super cute.
Oh my gosh.
Is that Kuzumbo chasing in the back?
Yeah. Yeah,
why is Kuzumbo? Kuzumbo, oh my god,
the Nidhi Kappa. The Nidhi Kappa looks vicious.
Right?
This is why you need to get a skin, because
these card arts are sick.
This is exactly why. And we will definitely see that his cuteness relayed as we see the in-game turnaround to get a closer look at the model as well. But I'm super happy. I know
they did a good job
about the axolotl taking the dub here. And that's this sick. One turned out awesome. I'm that's loving
really
the pink.
Cool, dude.
And axolotls are super cute. And we finally have one in Smite. It's awesome.
I wonder what his tail colors and acorn will like be.
Oh, yeah. That's definitely something to call out for all the new Ratatosker skins. Let's go ahead and take a listen to the voice pack for Raxolotl Ratatosker.
I can feel a great sense of adventure.
What is hanging out of the rat's ass?
Definitely is ready for the adventure on the battleground. I'm looking forward to this
Hell
one.
Yeah.
All right, last up for all the skins headed you guys' way next week, we have got Fallen Star Soul coming to the Odyssey Reckoning event. And this one is a little bit on the spookier, scary side, but it's got some high fantasy elements as well. And I love the dark takes and like this dark sorcerer kind of skin themes that we've got.
Whoa, what do you guys?
Oh, shit.
I haven't actually seen this one, so I really like the theme shift for Soul here. I don't know if we have anyone that's kind of like vicious like this. I like that a lot.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, we have like kind of like shadow dark.
Dude,
magic.
Whoever's doing their card art right now is fucking popping off.
Yeah.
I know. This one definitely looks awesome. I'm loving the shoulder pads and the hood. And as we go in game and take a look at the model, I'm sure we'll see some more details on that. But I was about to say, I know the effects are going to be awesome.
Oh, this is good as shit. Holy fuck. Oh,
that material is so cool. It's like kind of like faded gray into the purple. Oh, that's really simple,
but it has
a subtle hint of the color to kind of give off the dark vibes. I'm digging it. Let's go ahead and take a listen to the voice pack for Fallen Star Soul.
The mask, dude.
I foresee the battle and their end, our victory.
Nice.
All right. Well, that wraps it up for everything that's headed you guys' way next week. The bonus update, I believe, is October 20th. Hold me to that. Next Tuesday is when that's targeted
for. Oh, that's
for.
Bonus.
But we're going to get started on talking about the 7.11 update in just a second. But we've got some community news we want to break down for you guys. First up, I got to remind you guys about the Prime Gaming deal that's going on right now. If you're watching on Twitch, click that crown in the top right.
Hit
claim
that sub
your
button,
Code
baby.
Eater Bakasura skin just Go by linking skin. Your Prime account to
get
your
Prime Gaming
account and claiming your loot.
Get
the
Baka skin
there.
And then
the
come
skin
and sub
is
to the channel.
To this Prime
There's
deal,
the link.
So if you miss it, it's gone for a little bit. So you definitely do not want to miss out on this.
The
one.
Skin
this
is the best
awesome.
Baka skin in the game.
So this is one of Pond's favorite new skins, right?
It's the best Baka skin.
Yeah, definitely. Any Bakasura skin I'm going to play. It's free.
Oh, man. I don't want to see you on the battlefield playing Baka, especially with this skin. Jeez.
I know, right? All right. Next up, if you guys missed it, we announced our first ever Golden Bolts Awards. This is an award ceremony that's going to be happening the week of SWC that is dedicated to you guys, the community.
The Golden
so
Bolt.
If you head
I
over
want
to
a Golden Bolt.
SmiteGame.com, you guys can nominate
Golden
your favorite content creators, pro players,
Go nominate me
community members that you
right
feel
now.
Like have just killed it in the Smite community and deserve some recognition. Nominations close in a couple days, so you definitely don't want to miss out there. And we'll be having more information on social media for how the voting process is going to work next week. Next up, we've got The Reaping. The season of tricks and treats is upon us. It is coming your
what
way.
What is the link? It's
quick
like Golden
as
we Bolts
get ready for
something.
Halloween. And this is our yearly kind of spooky event. We're going to have lots of information headed on you guys' way on smitegame.com in a couple days. Lots of in-game events because maybe earn some free gems, maybe some free chests, plus a lot of bonus battle pass XP and stuff. So be on the lookout for that. Most definitely. So a couple more things. We've got our official Discord that's popping off. You guys want to join, hang out with Smite players, find some new friends, find some new teammates to play with. Head over to discord.gg/smitegame to join that. You've got a Smite-tober event that's happening right now. Cosplay, fan art, some top plays. It's a contest running. You guys actually can win some free gems. So if you head over to the Discord and hang out with us, you guys can find out more info on that. And last but not least for community news, we are nearing the end of the SPL season. We've got SPL cranking this weekend, as always. So you guys definitely do not want to miss out on the games that are happening. Things are going to kick off Friday at 3 p.m. with Space Station Gaming versus
Obey.
And then we've got a
Sanguine getting slapped.
A bunch of games. and you guys Knight's definitely don't want to miss out as we get closer to the World Championship.
Renegade's getting slapped.
What do you guys think?
Knight's getting slapped. Are getting slapped. Sigma getting slapped.
I mean, we've actually seen some pretty decent upsets. I don't know. I don't want to
know,
make a
right?
Call.
It's like the league is up in the air. Everybody's popping off. You love to see it. But
I'm not a caster. I don't have to predict it.
I know, right? You're not even worried. Hindu's writing the script anyway.
Oh, yeah.
But let's go ahead and start talking about the 7.11 update. And we're going to start off with the balance that's coming your way. But I do have just a couple of notes about the next two updates as we get towards the end of the year. So this 7.11 update and 7.12 update, they're going to be extended updates. So normally our updates last around 4 weeks. As we get closer to the holidays and people taking time off, these updates are going to be 6 weeks long. So as we get closer to, World Championships, you guys will have a little bit more time to play around with all the changes, have a little bit more time
to
play around
the battle pass. They're removing one update.
I also do want to note that there will not be any bonus updates for these updates as well, just because we've got some restrictions with some of our partners with console certification. Everybody's taking time to hang out for the holidays, so we definitely want to abide by those guidelines. But let's go ahead and hop right into Balance, Pawn, and Clumsy. And let's start off with items for 7.11 balance. And this one it's a little bit of a fix, but it's got some balance implications. Upgraded shell, block stacks from this item are no longer going to stack from multiple fires of the relic.
Correct. So this was something that we saw people do where
they're
buying
nerf. That's just,
shells
that's how it should
and
have been.
Popping them in unison, and then you get multiple stacks of block, more than just the two that the upgrade would give you. After looking at it and seeing how things interact, we felt like it made more sense and felt more intuitive for you to just refresh up to two stacks rather than get four stacks.
Like, this is how
so
it should have been originally. They should be just taking
blocks
away.
But if you're building only one shot on your team, or you actually space them out after people get their block stack reduced, you won't really notice a change.
Cool. All right, let's move right along. We got a couple more items to talk about. Next up is Guardian's Blessing. We're going to be doing a buff here, increasing the magical and physical protections from 5 up to 10.
Whoa,
yeah, it's a little bit help to the supports. I mean, obviously for the early game, Julian's been pretty lethal, and we've seen a little bit of starter stats increases for a couple of the other ones. So we wanted to make sure Guardian's Blessing felt sufficiently rewarded.
What?
All right, last up for items, Staff of Mirrodin getting a buff here. We're doing a cost reduction. That's going to come down from 3,000 down to 2,800.
Yeah, this item had a lot of spooky applications when people first tried to figure it out.
Happening?
I think people realized the cost and the power made it a little bit too prohibitive. And we agree that that actually ended up making it too prohibitive to really build. So we're just reducing the cost. We're going to let people have more freedom to explore this kind of really unique item without so much of a cost.
Holy fuck.
All right, that wraps it up.
Guardian's Blessing just doubled its
god. And we'll
protections
start off with a
out
god
of nowhere.
That I don't think I've ever said her name on the show before.
Oh,
let's
man.
Talk about Nox, guys.
All right,
we're going to be doing up for Nox here. And Shadow Lock, this ability is now going to deal pass-through damage to minions when it sits fired. Mm-hmm. And who wants to take this one? This is a big one.
Pawn, go ahead. I just want to preface it by saying, I know how much there's going to be a lot of uproar in the community. I as a mid and major lane player, have been wanting a change likes for a long time, but Pawn, go ahead and take it away.
Yeah, so Nox is definitely a point of discussion, almost on like the level of Loki, but not quite there, where people have like very strong feelings about her kit. One thing that we did notice that, especially in Conquest, her viability is very limited, which it feels okay in other modes, and largely that's due to her ability to clear. Shadow Lock, the pass-through, just kind of felt like it should do damage, it should do something. It didn't feel great that it just didn't do anything on passing through. So we're adding pass-through damage largely to help her in Conquest. We did some iteration on these numbers. This is really there just to supplement her clear, not allow her to use this ability to solo clear and save her two for silence and defense. But this should help her out a ton. And it's one of the things that a lot of Nox mains have really been requesting for some time. One small note is now this ability does AoE damage. It used to only be single target hitting a god. Mm-hmm. So it used to have 100% lifesteal coefficient, so you'd benefit from 100% of your lifesteal. It has now been changed to 33%
what
to be in
is
line
happening?
With all the other AoE abilities. So it's also a small
AoE
stay nerf technically, but also if you're hitting multiple minions, you're getting more lifesteal. So it kind of like balances
what's
out.
The
but
range? Is it like Silaru?
Conquest based off really popular community suggestions.
Yep,
most definitely. I'm definitely curious to see how this one shakes out. We'll see, guys. Let's go ahead and start talking about some Guardians here. Athena
bro, Nox
is
about to be fucking
first,
broken.
To Athena, her final
bro, Nox
basic attack
2-1
is now going
three
to
people.
This is exciting. I know the Olympians specifically have been asking about this for a long time. What do you guys think?
That's insane.
Yeah, exactly.
Dude,
we're talking about
Nox
confer,
was annoying
like
for you guys in
suggested.
Arena.
We've
Have
always been wanting
arena,
to find
boys.
You know adequate ways of bringing Athena back into relevancy a little bit. We've touched on her ulti and the damage
Athena
mitigation Cleaves? There, I think, back and forth. And we wanted to find another
Athena
point that would be something interesting. Just like with the Nox change, you know, maybe this is a little bit less interesting than that. But something the community suggested.
I said like every time I play her that it feels like it's a Cleave
auto attack, so we brought it in.
All right, next up we've got
Athena's
Clear
is gonna be
and
nuts
I believe
and lame
this is
too.
Actually another Olympian suggestion. We're gonna be making a change to Chug. Chug is now going to provide Bacchus with a buff of magical power per rank, and we're actually decreasing the mana cost on the ability as well.
What is this?
Yeah, Chug just felt like it didn't feel very great to rank up in a lot of ways. You were getting
bro,
some extra protections, but you were also increasing
patch.
Your mana cost, and the protections didn't feel that great to rank up. So we just wanted to give you a little
bro,
bit more.
Bacchus already has one of the
up,
highest win rates
more help
in
late game Bacchus,
silver,
so
gold,
you
and platinum.
A little bit of power in addition to the protections that you would normally get, and you're not going to feel like you're penalizing your mana pool by ranking this ability up if you choose to rank it up earlier.
This shit is crazy.
All right, moving right along. Bellona is up next. We're going to be doing some mana cost buffs to Shield Bash and Scourge, decreasing the mana cost on both those abilities.
Yeah, so Bellona's always a tricky one because if she ever gets too strong,
bro,
she starts
I'm
dominating
to play
solo lane pretty heavily.
And Athena.
She's got a lot of obviously different things that she can do. And because of that, because we want to encourage her stance swapping or swapping her weapon, so continuously we want to bring down the mana cost, make it a little bit less restrictive to do that kind of a gameplay.
These are good changes. Bellona's really annoying.
Yeah,
especially in the jungle, you move him so fast.
Yep, Shield Bash and Scourge, meta cost.
Shield Bash and Scourge for Bellona.
This is a crazy
next up, let's
patch.
Talk about Chalk. We're going to be doing a buff for Chalk here. Torrent, we're going to be increasing the protection buff duration, and hitting a god with Torrent now provides two protection buff stacks.
What?
Yeah, so Chalk, Torrent, the more targets you
what
hit, the more protections you get.
Bro?
It's actually quite a bit of protections. But late game, when you're
for
doing just team fighting phase where there's not really minions around for you to hit, not only did it last not really long, so you didn't get to benefit from the protections for too long, but it was also very difficult to actually get stacks, so you'd have to actually dash through and multi-hit multiple targets.
Yeah,
now when you use like
hit
a single or just two targets, you're going to get many more stacks for that, and you're going to feel way tankier in the late game team fight. So you can definitely get in and mix it up with the opponents pretty effectively.
All right, next up for balance, we're doing a shift for Dodgy, and I'll kind of break this down and then let you guys take it away. 1,000 cuts, we're going to be adjusting the damage from 15 to 115, and it's going to be 25 to 105 at max rank. And then we're also going to be increasing the physical power scaling from 30% to 35% per hit.
Yeah, Pot, I'm gonna let you take this one again because I know you
early game damage massive
detail.
Buff late game
yeah,
evens
so
out
1,000
because of
cuts felt a little bit weird as a dodgy jungle. Your first rank of it didn't feel like it really cleared that effectively, and then your second rank suddenly spiked your ability to clear very, very heavily. It just made her power curve in the early game
that is crazy
strange.
Though it took 40
so
damage off of it late
damage
game.
Per rank to be a bit more
but
consistent
added
with what we normally
40
do
damage
for
to it early
so your level one
game.
Clear is gonna be, feel better. Ranking up to rank two is just gonna feel like you've made the ability better, not significantly better. But because of the number shift,
that's crazy too.
Because
you rank dodgies
to
rank two in the jungle, and then you stop ranking it.
But we gave her some scaling to make up for it. So TLDR the change
because you max your one, then you go back and max the two.
Consistent, she scales to about the same place she used to.
That's actually crazy. He did this knowing how you're supposed to level the ability.
Wing Gust going to be
that is a nutty change. Actually, I've never seen anything like that.
Increasing the magical power scaling from 35% to 40%.
So this is. Obviously, we did a lot of changes to Isis and to several other gods
and
in that mid-season patch. And because of that, you know, everyone reacted pretty heavily and rightfully so. She was seeing a lot of play. But one by one, slowly, we're trying to find that mid-spot. So we're not really doing anything new here. We're reverting one of the nerfs that we did in the previous patch.
We're
just trying to find where we can bring her back.
Rank 3 is where it doesn't go up at all.
Without, you know, being her too high or too low.
She's still going to be doo-doo.
Up next, Jormungandr, as we start talking about some guardians here. Submerge, we're going to be increasing the knock-up height and decreasing the cooldown. So a pretty big buff, I'm sorry.
Justin, you didn't even donate, Justin. What do you mean you're $10?
Very interesting history of, like, so his support nature not being that high, but his soul lane being
months.
Very high, when he's
you.
Very good in the soul lane, he becomes a little bit too frustrating to deal with.
Knock-up height from 300 to 375, cooldown 2 seconds.
Here we actually wanted to focus on making his support and
happening?
Utility better. So his submerge, rather than increasing damage on anything that he has, is going to knock you up higher, So therefore, you're basically CC for longer, as well as he has a reduced cooldown on this, so he can do it more frequently. Just gives him more control and more contribution to team fighting directly, as opposed to necessarily like wave clear or like his ult damage and utility.
All right. Another god that I feel like I haven't said her name in a long
Storm
time.
Storm did not
Medusa
need a buff,
up
dude.
Next, we're going to be doing a buff for Medusa. And
another
Acid
one?
Spray is going to see its base damage increased from 90 to 270, and that's going to go 90 to 290.
So Medusa, we touched her Viper Shot somewhat recently, and that really helped her out. But unfortunately, after the initial
Five
hype,
damage,
you know, she wasn't really played as much. We want to see her play. We think she's really cool, and we think one of the places we can touch is the Acid Spray's base damage, more towards the end of the ranks, right? So her early game is still pretty decent.
Adding
but
pokes.
It starts falling off once
scaling,
you start getting
though.
Into ranks 4 and 5. This should help that a little bit.
Cool. Mm-hmm. All right. Next up on the list, Mulan. Divine Mastery is going to see its cooldown decreased from 100 seconds to 90 seconds at all ranks.
Buffing the ult to Mulan.
Yeah, I think during her initial release, and you can correct me if I'm wrong, Clumsy, on this.
It's a weird
like, the ultimate
change. It's like they
want
her to
giant team
do better early, even though she's already good
people,
early.
Knock up a whole bunch of people, damage a whole bunch of people. And so we put it at 100 seconds because we felt like this was going to be a very powerful ability. But people have learned the counterplays that she is rooted. She has to hit a target first. People have really learned how to play around this ability effectively. So it feels like it's just more on par with the standard level of ultimate. So 90 seconds makes more sense than something like 100 seconds.
Yep, exactly. And one other note on that is because the LT allows you to get experience on
I'm
each of the other abilities, having a lower
treatment.
Cooldown means that you can actually rank those
reduce
passives if you're using
protection.
The ultimate off cooldown, really. Because if you're waiting and delaying, then you're not going to really get a change on that.
Cool. All right, next up, we've got Neith. Seeing a buff to backflip again, we're going to be decreasing the mana cost on backflip from 70 to 110. And that's going to go down to 60 to 80. So that's a pretty significant mana cost decrease, guys.
Yeah, it's pretty significant mana cost decrease, but at the same time, if you look at just in a vacuum, it seems pretty normal. 70 to 110 is just, it's just some numbers that are a little bit archaic at this point, you know?
All right, let's move right along to Odin. And correct me if I'm wrong, guys, but I believe this is, if not a full, but maybe a partial revert of a past change that we did. Gungnir's Might, we're going to be increasing the pulse damage per hit.
Yeah, Gungnir's Might definitely contributed a lot to
Why?
His damage. This ability was one of like the strong points of his like rework. And we did a lot of nerfs to him after that rework. This is just kind of reverting one of those changes. You do have to be around a target. You do have to pulse it multiple times.
Why? It's 15
like
damage if you hit every pulse.
Now, people have really learned to play with the new.
And
rules.
Odin in the soul lane right now has a high, is like a 60%
right,
win or no, 56% win rate, 57% win rate.
This is
something crazy in plat and gold.
Yeah.
Standing Stones. Terra now gains cleave basic attacks on her entire hit chain while this passive ability is active. And I believe we're going to go in game very quickly and show it off, but I'll let you guys take it away and talk to me about the change.
Yeah, so if you thought the Dino one's spicy, this one's definitely there. Terra's
Jungle
been
Terra's back.
Really interesting as a support.
Because
we've seen,
back.
We've seen her, you know, support lane, we've seen
Let's
her soul
go.
Lane, and casual players don't really, it's really hard to clear effectively, especially in the
Jungle
early
Terra
game.
Was back
now,
because
if
you, had
you
no
utilize
clear.
Staying Stones passive, you can keep
now.
That up, you can keep the three healing
GG,
your allies while
everybody.
Using your auto attacks to help clear the wave and group
and
things
the
up
items
better.
Have changed
it's
since
really
then.
Giving her a lot more flexibility in both of the lanes.
Yeah, she's going to have, she's going to be so good in every role.
To help out her early game clear. Letting her actually get more
support clears
use out of, like the level one abilities. Often when you're just level one, you feel like
Wait,
you don't
it's
really
full
have
clear,
that
cleave.
Options that you have to like actually
it's
help
full
your lane
cleave.
Clear. Now you actually have this AoE punch, which also applies the slow and the bonus damage. So
it's a full
definitely,
cleave.
Definitely something.
It's 100% cleave.
Really, this is gonna help out her level one to three most of anything. After that,
what
she's gonna feel good to just be punching people in an AoE.
Once you get to team fights and stuff, I can't imagine this being a massive, you know, buff to her. So
how,
it's really
what's the range, bro? Can I run auto attack?
This is definitely gonna help her significantly in the lane phase, I think.
Yeah, her clear is gonna be fucking
right
nuts.
Let's talk about Vulcan up next. Gonna be getting a buff to Earthshaker. We're gonna be increasing the damage at close range from 60% to 75% of the max.
Okay,
damage.
That's actually a really good buff.
Oh yeah, so for this one,
that's
Vulcan,
a really good buff.
Melee range use of it is often something that you want to do because your team is kind of set up to fight there. You can't always go for the super long range hits. But the 60% or the, I guess the 40% penalty on it often felt very punishing.
I am mind blown
can really contribute
so far
as much as you
by
to.
These changes.
Vulcan is a mid range we've seen some mixed success with, but we
honestly,
want to give
this might
little
be
bit of extra boost
the
to
most
team fighting around his team and being rewarded for still being close
like,
to the fight. Hype, even if he does
but
do
under hype hats I've ever seen in my life.
Pentacle steals.
Bro, they didn't say anything about this shit.
Shibalanke, Rising Jaguar are going to be seeing a buff here, and we're going to be increasing the physical power scaling by 20%.
Yeah, 20%. So Shibalanke, we did a lot of changes to the Branching Bola, trying to help out his early game, and I think we successfully did that with the meta cost, with the damage changes. We wanted to find something else for him, because with the latest set of nerfs,
he's solid buff.
Gotten down a little bit further than we'd like. So Rising Jaguar is a place we fell on. Back in the old days, if you remember, there used to be a great combination between Poison Darts and Rising Jaguar. It still exists, you still gain bonus damage, but that scaling just is generally really low. 30%, even with the additional you get from Poison Darts, it's still really low. So this should help out a little bit and bring him back into the late game.
Reread the Nox changes. Right. Oh, so it's not multi-hit on gods. It's just it can cross through multiple creeps.
Balance round as we move.
Which they said like eight times.
Yep.
Zhang Kui gonna be getting a buff here, and what a fitting way to kind of sign off here on balance.
Oh,
Book of
yeah.
Demons. We're gonna be increasing the base damage, and then Recall Demons. We're gonna be increasing the magical power scaling.
That's nuts because Zhang's doing okay in like Golden Plot too.
Zhang Kui has largely kind of fallen out of relevance. He kind of like goes in and out of being relevant based off like often how we give how much protections we give him in his passive. This is more focused on actually making him a bit more of a kind of damage bruiser if you want to go that route versus just making this tank that can just do.
I like these changes, man. These are fucking crazy.
Book of Demons.
Nox has clear. Terra has clear. Athena has clear.
And so boosting that early game damage is going to help.
Dodgy too early buff.
Be more aggressive. Why the recall demon scaling change is going to be the thing that
this shit is wild.
Damage. This is your reward for building damage and not being so tanky. Just to make him a little more flexibility in his build.
Nerf the Rama.
All right, guys. Well, that wraps it up for all the balance that's coming out in the TMNT update.
Nox 1 can now clear.
Almost turtle time, guys, I promise. But we have a couple more skins that are coming out that we want to highlight.
Yeah, I
want to
see these skins, bro.
Please,
let me see these skins.
So let's kick it off with the Odyssey Reckoning, the update that's coming up in November 3rd. And we'll start it off with Paintballer Jing Wei. And this one, I definitely got a sneak peek at the card art earlier. And this one.
Oh, let's go.
What do you think?
Oh, I love it. Like, for some of these gods, we get a sneak preview early, we see the concepts. I've not seen this. I love the vibrancy. I love the color palette. Like, just all the things going on. I mean, which makes sense because of how, like, all the paint going on.
Cool. And all right, Jing Wei fan. Baytex said this was super important. We do have the default voice actors for Jing Wei. AJ said, you have to tell people just because I know it's a big deal. So let's go ahead and take a look at the, we've got the Turner on here for the model and definitely loving the yellow and pink vibes and the paintball gun. You see the green splats. She's definitely been in the heat of battle. Let's go ahead and take a listen to the voice pack. For
not bad. It's cool. It looks like a fucking Valorant skin.
I'm like ready to get those wins.
Or Overwatch.
She is definitely ready to get the dubs, and I'm super excited for this one. Next up, we got Shadow Howler Hunbots, and this one is I actually got a chance to get a sneak peek at
Hunbots
earlier.
20th skin.
And this one's
is
kind of
good?
In the theme of our Shadow Forest slash Shadow Spirit skins. And as we take a look at the card art here, you guys will definitely see
what
the
fuck
do you think?
Is this?
Show I was
me the
not
in-game
expecting
now.
Something so cute looking.
Show me the in-game right
so
now.
It's so adorable.
I know, right?
Show me
a
the
little
in-game
creepy,
right now.
But mostly adorable.
Show
see,
me
that. Yeah, I've not seen
it now.
Like, you don't
is
know
bad,
whether you
want to
run up and hug it or just stay away because it's going to kill you.
I think that's pretty awesome, though.
Yeah, I definitely love the details with the robes and some
show
of the,
me
the
in-game.
Shining glowy effects. And I'm sure we'll see some of that as we take a look at the,
this is Hunbats,
the model
bro.
Turnaround here that we're getting ready to go into. But definitely looking forward to
this. Yeah, this skin is fucking
I love
this.
The
I love
this skin.
Cardar definitely looks a little better, but this looks
know,
really
right?
good.
It's awesome.
Look at the fucking tail
like,
colors.
As simple as the mask is that with the glowing eyes.
Man, dude, this is Hunbats needed something special. They're going
to
give him a 20th skin. They did a good job.
Shadow Howler Hunbats.
Spirits, these trespasses will be quelled in your name.
I hope his weapon looks cool when swinging around because that skin is good.
Definitely don't want to give this guy a high five or a hug or anything. All right, last up before we hop into the TMNT Battle Pass, we want to give you guys an early look at the next skin and the final skin coming you guys' way in the viewer store. We've got Valiant Huntress Artemis, and this one definitely is super, super awesome. She's got like the royal vibe, but a little bit more of a fantasy, almost futuristic almost. As
this
you look,
is another
take a look
boring
at the Tusky.
Fucking
what do you
skin
think,
for Tusky and
oh
bitch
my gosh,
ass Artemis.
Tusky. He's so cute. Look at him in the armor in the spectral like form.
The spectral snout. Look at it. I want to bong her.
Yeah.
Oh, no yeah, one can, dude. Tusky's out for like half a second. Why is Tusky even mentioned when you're looking at skin?
You're earning viewer points, but also we kicked off our partner program trial. We've got viewer points on all of our Smite partner members channels right now as well. So if you're hanging out and you want to watch anybody that's in the Smite partner program, you'll be earning viewer points as well. That way, you guys will be able to unlock the skin in the viewer store.
This is kind of a boring viewer skin. I'm not gonna lie.
For Valiant Huntress Artemis.
This is
archers. Prepare for battle. This will be a long and cold night.
That is Valiant Huntress Artemis. Definitely looking forward to that. Headed you guys' way in the viewer store when the TMNT update goes live. Well, speaking of TMNT, it's turtle time. It's time for the turtle power.
Hey.
We'll be right back on the other side of this break to go over the TMNT battle.
Why are we having a break? Will you show me the skins? Actually, the boss were sick. This is a good ass patch, but I was only here originally for these skins.
Cowabunga!
Is the prestige worse than the other ones?
Welcome back, everybody. I lost the hat, got a headband, because you know what time it is. I got to rep my boy Donnie for the TMNT Battle Pass, and I'm super stoked. I hope you guys grab
I'm
some
mad
drinks,
cause
grab some snacks.
The Mercury one's the one
pizza.
I like the most, but I fucking hate him
into
the most.
This awesome
he's my least
pass,
favorite of all the fucking turtles.
Way. And here to break things down with me, I've got Clumsy with me still, but also I had to bring in the big guns, our resident TMNT fan and stan, Mel from the animation team. How you doing, man?
Yo, how you doing?
Yo, what's good? What's good,
Keon? Yo, you ready to talk about the turtles? Yeah, we can hear you, man.
Word. Yo, I'm
all right, let's get
more than ready. Let's do it.
I know, right? Let's get right into it. I am stoked. So if you guys don't know what the Battle Pass is, our Battle Pass is our kind of buy patch event update that we have that comes out. You guys will be able to purchase this. It's got a free track,
good vibes,
and a
for
premium
sure
track that
that,
you
that's the energy they
gems
need all the time.
And as you play the game, you'll be able to earn battle points to unlock all sorts of cool rewards. We've got turtle skins, lots of different profile cosmetics that you guys will be able to earn. The premium track is going to be 750 gems that unlocks Leonardo Osiris instantly. And speaking of Leonardo Osiris, let's go ahead and get right into it as we start kicking off this TMNT Battle Pass section. The card art looking dope. Mel, all right, I got to kick things off. Who's your favorite turtle before we get in?
Bro, it's same as you, baby. It's Donatello all right, the
let's
way.
Get it.
Yeah.
Ever since I was a little Mel, it was Donatello.
A little Mel. All
right. Well, my brother was definitely a Leo stan. So let's go ahead and take a look at this model. And as we get into it, let's talk about kind of how we went about the turtle pairings here. And Mel, I know you put in a ton of work, but we really wanted to kind of get really close with the fighting styles of the turtles. And that's how we kind of decided on who, what god got what turtle skin. So, of course, Osiris, our a resident quick attack dual wielder. And this one's looking super slick. Before we head in game, let's take a listen
to the
voice
pack. You're not even
going
to know it's fucking
Leonardo Osiris.
You're going to have no idea this is fucking Osiris.
The name's Leo. I've got three rowdy brothers who always give me a hard time, but I keep them in line, usually.
Yeah.
There we go. The lean, mean turtle machine, leader of the team.
I'm so excited.
I know, right? I'm ready to get right into it. So as we get ready to go in game, Pawn, our resident driver here, is definitely going to be beating up on the Shredder bots. We took a break from Odin.
Oh,
and as we look
Pawn
at our hit chains,
look at your boy.
Oh my goodness. Look at your boy go. Mel, look at what,
all
what
right,
your
bro. I'm playing Osiris every game. Fuck Mercury.
So definitely had a lot of fun. one trying to get, like, so
look at the three.
This is
all right, this is right, so
we were trying to figure out how are we gonna solve the
these
whole
are my colors
Osiris
too, bro. So we're doing Osiris
thing,
every game,
you know, and blend it in with the ninjutsu style that we got going on with the turtles. And we were just like, yo, Leonardo is the most kind of spiritual out of all the brothers, so let's right, just keep yeah. it. Let's just keep it magical. Let's just keep it kind of spiritual. So we definitely went with that with our boy here.
There's showing off that passive.
Yeah, that glow for the passive. Nice.
There was a lot of back and forth. Like, how are we going to show off the passive for Osiris and tie it in with the Ninja Turtles? And we were just like, yo, let's make it look like he's got mutagen just coursing through his body. Nice. Hardcore.
Exactly, yeah. This one is so dope. All right, Pond, can I get a max range Osiris ult, please? Just so we can see the full finesse of what's going on. Definitely my favorite part.
Bro, they made Osiris ult half the fucking...
No,
oh, there we go.
Oh my so god. Sick, I'm literally playing Osiris that's every game, bro. He doesn't look clunky, yeah, dude. Osiris clean. Always feels oh, clunky.
Yeah, we had
smooth.
big fans all over throughout every discipline. You know what I'm saying? Working on these guys, trying to get them as true to form as we can. And
oh,
I
you
think
understand.
Really,
this is actually so
really
fucking good. This
know,
Osiris
like,
is so
loving this one.
Fucking
like yeah, you know my Donnie Stan. Oh,
okay.
Every the recall, we got the custom.
Okay, I'm literally just gonna play Osiris.
Here.
I don't even care how good the other
looking
skins are.
Sick.
This is nuts.
Yeah, definitely.
This is my favorite
Leo
fucking
Osiris
dude too.
Probably gonna be my
Leo's
second.
The best. Osiris now the best. Good thing you get Osiris
here.
Jungle right now.
It's definitely gonna be my favorite. Donatello, Sun Wukong. We got the Donnie Stans coming in. Definitely
so
my favorite turtle.
Why did Nerf Wukong with this coming out though?
I love how we have just the different kind of just the small little touches on all the different turtles to kind of tell them apart. So Donnie's got his goggles, and as we get into Wrath and Mikey later on, everybody's got, you know, they're all the TMNT and they're all the team, but they've got the subtle nuances to be able to, you know, differentiate them from each other, right?
Yeah, for sure. So Donatello's, I mean, aside from him having, you know, a different weapon, different color bandana and stuff like that, he's got the goggles on the head to show he's very techy. He's got like a wrist-mounted computer that he messes with. And then we're probably going to show it, but he's got something else.
Yeah, we're going to show it.
Yeah,
we got to show it. You already know.
So actually the animation point on, because you know he's my boy, so I was like, I'm taking this one. You know what I mean?
Right?
So
yeah, let's go.
There's a lot of love. I put a lot of love. Me and everybody. I wasn't just alone on this. Everybody put a lot of love in this, but I was like on people like, no, it's got to move like this. He's got to do
right?
this.
Yeah. Most definitely. Well, before we go in game and show off Donnie, let's take a listen to his voice pack.
Donnie here. I'm the brains of this operation. I invent gadgets, weapons, and cool vehicles to keep me and my brothers safe.
Yes.
There we go. And I have a feeling we'll see some of those gadgets as we start looking at some of these abilities here. I'm ready. And we're getting ready to go in game right now. There we go, my man Donnie. All right, let's go ahead and start looking at some of these abilities. And as you can see, the basic attack chains, everything's been done up to show off the ninjutsu vibe. All right,
Osiris definitely better so far.
Mel, you took point. I'll let you take it away, man. Any Easter eggs or anything fun you want to talk about?
I mean, so Donatello and Sun Wukong have very similar fighting styles. You know, they both have the staff and stuff like that. So we had a mandate to kind of try and keep these characters looking as close as we can to the base god, so there was as little confusion as possible. So the attack chain for Donatello is very, very, very similar, and the ability as well, very similar to Sun Wukong. His in-hand attack chain does have a little bit of an Easter egg, as his last hit is a roundhouse kick, because we want to throw some of that ninjutsu in there. Yeah, that was
nice.
A personal touch that I think it read pretty well, and it kind of brought the ninjutsu, you know, into the whole thing. It's pretty fun.
For sure. Let's take a look at the 72 transformations here.
Come here, you. Nice. This is what would be the ox form.
There. Yeah. Charging forward with the bow staff on point.
Got Tiger.
Yeah. So Donatello changing into. Donatello changing into animals probably wouldn't have worked too good, so we kind of did like the Sun Wukong Dark Lord skin treatment.
I don't know if this skin's just not as good or what, but I think that...
Yeah, what's he riding on there?
The Osiris skin literally just...
What is that? No, right?
I don't know. You might have to do the... Yeah, you might have to do the eagle.
This looks cool. Okay, that's cool. That's sick. But like, the Osiris skin was so clean.
Your boy riding a turtle drone.
All right, that's fucking dope.
There we go.
That's the best part of the three.
Oh, loving it, man.
That's by far the best part of the three.
I believe he pulls out the drone for the ultimate as well.
Right?
Yep, he's sure it does. So this was another kind of, we had to be clever about how to present this too. Donatello being kind of techie, we were like, well, how are we going to have him? Because he goes invisible. How are we going to do this? So we did this, we had this effect on him to make it kind of look like holograms or like digitization that he was kind of hiding himself. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, dude, definitely. It's cool.
Did my boy justice.
But they should have shown Kong, fucking Osiris skin first. That skin is way better.
I hope all my friends are ready.
I had to practice.
Dope. It's like I'm a fucking 8 out of 10 skin. That Osiris skin was 10 out of 10.
Drone 2? Yeah.
Yeah, that's awesome. So all the turtles have, you know, their own custom recall animations and stuff here. He calls the drone to go back to base.
Yeah, it does look this and one's sounds and feels sick. Like a regular Wukong, but that Osiris skin did not. It didn't feel
that's
like
cool, but rude.
Osiris at all.
You know, he wouldn't say he's rude himself. But let's talk about Raphael Loki. And definitely, he's got the Band-Aids out because, you know, he's been tussling. Yep. Got the socks ready to go. This one is super awesome. Mel, are you a Raph stan? How do you feel about Raph?
I mean, yo, look. Ever since I was a little one, you know, Raph had a kind of like an attitude change between like the cartoon I grew up with and then the movie. And then I instantly fell in love with the kind of bad boy, rough and tumble movie version. And we stayed true to that with this one. Raph is like, he's the dude you call when you need something done. So that's why I gotta give a lot of love to Raph.
Oh, for sure. All right, well, I believe we've got a turnaround video ready here to kind of show off the model just a little bit before we go in game. And as you can see, he's ready to go. He's got the fighting stance ready. He's got the bounce going on. Let's go ahead and take a listen to the voice pack for Raphael Loki before we go in game.
So hype, yo.
Raphael is cool but rude? Give me a break.
For sure. Call back to the theme song there.
Did you know that was the voice line coming up? Because you cued that up perfectly, Isaiah.
Oh, I did, yeah.
Oh my god.
For sure. And yeah, let's go ahead and get I'll take a look at the kit for Raphael Loki here. And I've got a note here. Things are still a little bit work in progress here. We've got an issue with the vanish on Raphael Loki. It's not gonna be representative of the final product. So we won't be able to show it off in full glory for you guys, but definitely as we get towards PTS and the full release, you guys will be able to see what it looks like. Mel or Clemzy, I'm not sure if you guys have had a chance to play with Raphael Loki or against him, but do you have any insight on how the stealth is going to look? Oh, the agonizing visions look so crisp.
Yeah, the agonizing visions.
Look at how clean it is.
That
like,
pose where he's like leaning like on the ground. Detail, that's like straight... Nuts. Loses when they figure out Master Splinter is gone and he gets like angry like that in the movie. That's where we took that from, and it's dope. But the stealth I don't think it's gonna look too dissimilar from Loki's stealth if I recall correctly. So he's just gonna go very shadowy.
Material we apply on.
Yeah.
Sounds good. I love the agonizing visions, how instead of the poison dagger, you got the ooze just dripping down. It's just a super nice touch.
That new Loki 3 with this is really awesome.
Yeah, it looks so good on Raph, dude, because it's just pure fury. Just pure rage.
I know, right? Looking sick.
Nice.
Yeah, this one's super good. Let's take a look at the ultimate once Pawn gets done beating up the Shredders.
Oh, and the thing that's dripping on him in the two is the mutagen canister. We made sure to get that in there.
Secret of the ooze, man.
That's right.
It's cool. Still Osiris dumpsters all over this.
Yeah, this one's super dope. And I believe we got some recalls to show off here.
I like the recalls, dude.
Two of the turtles go into a manhole. So I think it's Leo and Raph go into a manhole. And then Donnie takes off on his drone, and we'll see what Mikey does.
There we go. Yeah. Speaking of Mikey, let's get right into Michelangelo Mercury here. Got the skateboard and the headphones ready. I'm digging the vibes. And like I was saying earlier, all the turtles have, you know, something that's unique to them, just to kind of give them that added flair and separate them a little bit from the group. So you already know Mikey. He's got the music bumping. He is skateboarding, doing the tricks. And I'm super ready for this one. Mel, what do you think about Michelangelo Mercury?
Fucking Leo Baez. Bro, I didn't even.
Who doesn't like Michelangelo?
I wanted this to be my favorite.
Right? If you don't like Michelangelo, he's the heart and soul of the group. You know what I'm saying? If you don't like Michelangelo, I can't trust you as a human being.
Damn.
Oh, man. Super sick. Well, I am ready to definitely take a look at the model here. We've got a turnaround video to show off. He's got the new chaka going.
His board is
ready
huge.
To skate off. Let's take a listen to the voice pack for Mikey.
Oh, bro, he's got to be right cool. This is going to be sick.
Mikey here. I love video games, skateboarding, pranking my brothers, and duh, pizza.
Pretty much, he likes just about everything that I like. It's super dope. Who doesn't like pizza, right? So as we move on into game here, and let's kick it off here. Loving the skateboard. And I believe he has the skateboard utilized in some of his tricks here. But we've got the basic attack chain going. Mel, anything special with using Nunchaku?
Why does that give off decent Mercury auto attack vibes? Melees?
All right, so first of all, because I've been slacking on this. The lead on Michelangelo, lead on Raphael, where animator Matt McCullough, lead on Leonardo was animator Louis Rapinski, and of course I was Donatello. So like using the nunchucks with Michelangelo, I mean you can't have Michelangelo just have him punch people. He's got to use the shots. You know what I'm saying? So it was a no-brainer. So we just had to
with the two pop, this looks sick. I like
work
that.
Our magic to try and make it look as dope as possible. And this one went through a lot of iteration.
That is really good looking.
Clean. You got the skateboard. You already know.
I like the sound.
Yeah, the skateboard. We had to use the skateboard, man. The rocket skateboard, and he gets on that and flies. Like that was another thing. We had to figure out how are we gonna translate like the pure speed of Mercury to like Michelangelo, because you know he's a turtle, but he's not a god that can move the speed of light. So we're like, rocket board.
Rocket right, board.
Let's take a look at the rocket board pun. Fire off that ultimate.
Oh,
yeah,
nice.
That's pretty cool.
I remember when I saw that, I was like, this is genius.
Yeah, that's pretty smart.
I don't want you to slow-mo it. I kind of want you to slow-mo, but I don't want you to slow-mo because sometimes things break. But he, like, jumps on that board and just lets it take him for a ride.
Yeah, that's so sick. Dude, Pond is he's got the commands going.
Look it. Boom!
Nice.
Tell me that joint isn't like dope. That was
this Brock Cyrus one by far the best. This is right definitely there. The second best.
Shout out to Brock.
I know, right? Shout out to the entire team. Like art, animation, rigging, effects design. Everyone put FX in so really much work for this battle pass, and it definitely comes through. I can definitely tell that there were so many fans of the show working on this battle pass. But he's got the skateboard. So one thing that we haven't touched on yet is that all the turtles have a VXG. And we definitely want to show that
they're all on skateboards,
before
right?
You know, stop talking about the battle pass. So, of course, you can skate on the battleground, but you know, if you hit that ollie and jump real quick, Pond.
What? Okay. Okay, bop. What the bop. Fuck?
Show your moves bop. Off.
Bro, what? Bop.
I know, right? Sick. And if you guys noticed, we've actually got a
Holy
set of tricks
shit.
That are actually randomized for every time that you jump.
That's fucking crazy. What
Yeah,
the
I remember when people
fuck?
Saw the trailer for the first time, they're going crazy for everything. And they're just like, yo, we better be able to ride the skateboard. And guess what? Yeah, you can.
Oh, most definitely. Yeah. This one is looking clean.
This is going to be one of the
so
best
that is
overall movement
the
specials in the game.
Of the TMNT Battle Pass. But before we cut off and start showing off some of the prestige skins, we want to show off some, of, some of the you know, profile cosmetic items that you guys can
Dude,
get
that's
in the Battle
so
Pass.
Good.
So I believe we've got the Mouse Reward skin that we want to show off. We've got a jump stamp and global emotes from the Radical Chest that we'll be getting into in just a second. But lots of fun callbacks to the show. All the different gadgets and stuff are represented. I believe there's a turtle drone ward, the mouse ward is super sick. Mel, what was it like kind of coming up with all of these references for the different aspects of turtles to do different cosmetics for it?
I mean, we we had to just call back on our deepest, darkest childhood. Well, maybe not darkest, our deepest, most specially held childhood memories about what we remember, what we liked from the show. You know, like what we liked. We're fans, you know what I'm saying? So, like, yo, where can we get as much bang for our buck for trying to bring everything that we can to this battle pass for these turtles? And, you know, it shows everywhere. Real quick, shout out to Rigging Crew, specifically Jeff Rains, because we're talking about Michelangelo. Those nunchucks were not a joke to try and rig,
for sure.
And he did magic to get them going. So big ups to the Rigging Crew for sure, especially Jeff Rains.
This one definitely turned out super sick. So you're calling out, you know, the childhood memories and stuff. So of course we had to think about the 1987 yeah. show.
Are they going
to
show us?
And that's kind of how we got Splinter the inspiration for the prestige name? Track for all the turtle skins. As we go into, like, we're going to go right back in order. Moving? We're going to start with Leonardo Osiris, but they're getting a little bit radical on the prestige track and they've got the animated vibe. This one looks super awesome, and I'm just going to ask production to just go through all of the turtles and the turnarounds, and so we just kind of talk about turtles for a few minutes. So we got Leonardo up first, and Mel, what's your favorite part of the
Splinter.
Show?
I thought they said they were going to. Smite?
I wish you guys could see the smile on my face. It is massive. Well, wait, I missed your question, bro. Say it again.
I was just going to say, like, what was it like just being a fan of the show and then being able to bring that?
All right, I think the animation one's better.
Dude, I've waited 33 years to say that I worked on something as professionally important as the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles are. And I can't tell you how excited I am to bring this to everybody in Smite, man. It was just, it was a dream come true. When I first heard announced, I was like, there's no way. This is impossible. And it became a reality. And I'm just like, we try to bring it home.
I remember being in a meeting with you, Mel, I think, when you heard that. You're like, there's no way. Like, we need to do this.
For real.
I know, right? We'll move along to Donatello, Sun Wukong, and I'm definitely loving the vibe. When I think about turtles, I think of the old arcade game. Me and my buddies going to the pizza buffet, hitting up the arcade, and spending like $30 in quarters just to hit that final level, man. So
I'm
awesome.
Glad you brought that up. Keep an eye out. Keep an eye out for a special little Easter egg that ties that back to the arcade show or the arcade game.
Nice. The thing about turtles is there's so much source material to pull from. So as we get into Raphael here, there's just so much to pull from. Everybody, I feel like no matter what generation you're in, you've got a version of Turtles that you reminisce to and think about. So I'm definitely excited for players to get their hands on this. And again, man, I'm loving the prestige, just the more animated vibes, because
I think I like the prestige more too. I think the 1987 cartoon. We'll see once we get to play them.
The movies were dope, and then as we even get closer to
the art on these, just looks 2000 series.
We were talking about Rise of the TMNT today, Mel. There's just so much turtle goodness, so much turtle goodness out there. It's so awesome.
I'm a big fan of the 2012 CG one.
For sure, yeah. And then our last prestige track skin here, before we start talking about the Radical chest, because we got Splinter and Shredder to show off too. We've got Radical Michelangelo Mercury, always got the pizza on deck, always got the music playing, the nunchucks. And as you can see in the card, I'm not sure if you guys saw it, but the Easter egg in the trailer, he's eating the pizza from Chef Vulcan's Pizza, man.
So I mean, have they determined how many skins are coming out for this? Right? Like, do we know if it is?
That's a great way to tie them all in.
Yes, definitely a crossover. I know we had
everything is actually in the game, or did they like list everything that's in the game somewhere?
Of fun to work on. So as we start talking away, transitioning away from the battle pass and start talking about the Radical chest, we've got Splinter Hachiman and Shredder Robin in this chest. They're also going to be available for direct purchase if you don't want to.
Dude, this Hachi skin better be good, man. Please,
you can either get it in the chest or purchase it for 1,200 gems. But Splinter Hachiman, this one is super fun, and I know the main question is like, what is he going to ride on in his ult? Well, we're definitely going to show that off here.
20 skins
were there. You got to show the model first and take a look at some of the details from Master Splinter here.
Yeah.
Yes.
God damn! Look at the other ones.
This is clean. I love it.
This was a magnum opus of an idea. We were like, who are we gonna put Splinter on? We're like, yo, we have a Japanese god. He's an archer. Splinter's got our ties to the archer. You know what I'm saying? You got the staff. You could hide a sword and a staff. It's gotta be Hachiman. And it just worked perfectly. Look at his feet. Look at his feet. Yo. Yeah. Hachiman doesn't have feet like that. Look what we did to Hachiman's feet.
So much work. Let's go ahead and take a listen to the voice pack for Splinter Hachiman before we go in game.
I am Splinter, and I will do anything for my sons.
Oh my goodness.
Chill. Anything, including hop on the battleground of the gods here. And as we show things off, I'll just ask Pawn to start firing off some arrows here and showing off some of the abilities. This one's looking super sick. Oh, nice. He's got kind of like the spiritual energy there for some of the ranged autos.
Yeah. Another direct tie-in from the movie. We're like, how are we going to make this happen? We're like, yo, he's got that scene in the movie where he like visits his son at the campfire and it's like this blue fire and stuff like that. We're like, let's do that.
There we go. I know, right? I'm loving just the callbacks, man. It's super awesome that the attention to detail and the love that went into it. But
the actual detail is getting dope. Ultimate. The abilities, I think, are. Well, we'll see the ult, I guess.
I'm ready for it.
Don't do it to him. Don't do it to him. You did it.
Okay. What is the turtle, man? At least they did something with the ult. That looks, okay, that looks good.
So, I forget who came up with the idea, but it was a genius one. We're like, well, I remember my idea was like, maybe we should put him on a turtle motorcycle or something. They were like, nah, hold up. The turtle van. How are we going to make that work? This is how we did it.
And of course,
there it is. Easter
egg.
Great slow-mo.
Who's that in the driver's seat?
Who's driving?
Who's driving?
Casey Jones, April O'Neil in the turtle.
Oh my god. Okay, I didn't even know that's in there. That's amazing.
That's how they squeeze them in. That was so smart, man.
Oh my goodness. So much work. Oh, you know we had to get Casey and April in here somehow. So dope.
April driving, Casey just kicking it with his arm out to the side, like, take us home, baby.
I know, right? Yeah. but yeah, that is Splinter Hachiman. And I'm not sure, Mel, do we got any other, like, special, like, any call-outs back to the show for Splinter before we move on to Shredder?
I don't think so. I mean, he was just, we just kind of had to fit Splinter on the Hachiman, so... We just, everything's in the model and the effects and stuff like that. I don't think there's any special callbacks outside of that.
For sure.
But
yeah,
we did put some work in there.
He had a custom recall showing off some of the ninjutsu, you know, because he is the master.
I know he can dance. Can you dance? Hachiman can dance. So looking at Splinter
dancing. He doesn't have the dance.
Is a treat.
Looks like he doesn't have the you know.
That's all right.
You guys can test that out in PTS. All right, let's go ahead and talk about Shredder Robin. This is our last skin in the TMNT Battle Pass / Radical Chest crossover.
I am afraid this skin's gonna be boring.
I gotta give a shout out to
Stu. They need to make it not boring because Robin is a boring character in general. If you're
making the dance,
oh, he's dancing.
Just kidding.
Oh, that's amazing. He's got to hit the go ninja, go in the background. But yeah, like I was saying, I got to give a shout out to Stu Harrington for the card art for both Splinter and Shredder. This Shredder card art is amazing. And this is just, it reminds me, you know, the movie where Shredder took the 1v4, came out on top. He got the quadra kill, all the broken weapons on the side, but you got Raph in the background. Maybe. Is that Raph in the trench coat? We'll never know. But as we get ready to take a look at the model here, we'll be able to see just the details in the armor and stuff. Mel, how do you feel about Shredder? You a Shredder fan?
Nah, man.
He said nah.
He said nah.
I gotta roll with the boys, man. I can't get on Shredder's side. Nah, man, Shredder's dope, man. He's the quintessential villain, man. He's just
for sure.
He's just gonna do what he needs to do to get the job done, and he just looks like a badass. So yeah, everybody likes Shredder, man. Everybody likes a good bad guy.
I know, right? Let's go ahead and take a listen to the voice pack for Shredder Robin, and we'll go in game.
I've molded myself into perfection. Look upon me and no fear.
Yeah, he is definitely ready to take out some turtles and some rats if they come across his way. He's got the Foot Clan backing him up, ready to go in game and show off some of these ninjutsu moves. I'm loving it. This is just like the perfect matchup. When I think of Shredder, I just think of hand-to-hand combat, quick, and this just looks
and I like
awesome.
His autos. Usually don't like Ravana. I mean, it is kind of the same autos. I think just the claws make it look better.
Right? Ravana's assassin, right?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, yep. So yeah, it was just a perfect kind of setup, man.
you know, Robin already does kind of like karate, martial artsy moves, you know, Shredder's a ninja, so it just boring.
For sure. Cool, but boring.
I'm loving the effects here too. You've got the blacks and purples. Clean.
Boom.
Ultimate literally, they should have shown Leo last. They should have opened with these two and just built up the fucking Leo, because
yes,
it's very obvious these were just kind of thrown in.
Turned out great. I can't wait to play with all these skins in game, man. I don't know about you guys. This is super dope.
Pretty boring.
Yeah.
Ah, she's getting kind
of
boring too.
I'm waiting for a team of four. The team of the four turtles and then the knockoff turtle, Kuzumbo. All in a team. Just rolling down the lane.
Yeah, I really wish they had saved the best for last.
But hey, guys, it wasn't up to us. Splinter just said his ninjutsu wasn't up to snuff, you know?
Yeah,
so
he tried.
It is what it is.
He tried.
Right? Well, that wraps it up for the TMNT crossover, the Battle Pass, and Radical Chest. Headed you guys' way on November 3rd. But we also want to take a little bit of time, since this is an extended update. We've got another round of skins that we want to show off that are coming your way on the 17th. And got some super exciting things here. We're going to start off with the Odyssey Reckoning. And first on the list is Sunken Sorcerer Poseidon. This is going to be November 17th.
Damn, there's a lot of skins. Reckoning. It's cool, and but this one, just a redo I'm the of the fucking, what is it, the Hades skin? Isn't there a skin that looks just like this?
It's, I got no words.
I was talking to Ben. Yeah. And
the colors and the helmet and everything.
I was talking to Ben on the arcade, and he was like, yo, we got to show this one off in game.
Yeah, what are the tentacles?
Best Kraken that we've ever done.
The Kraken better be sick if they throw it in the card art.
To show it off. So I believe we'll be able to go in and look at the model first and listen to the voice.
Oh, Odin. Odin has a skin like this. Yeah, yeah.
It's going to show it off in game. But this color scheme, I'm definitely digging it. The black cyans, hints of purples and grays and dark blues. And it looks like he's chilling with Cthulhu for this one, or somebody from the Great Old Ones pantheon. This one is super awesome.
Ooh, that arm is even more old.
There's the model turning around there. Oh my goodness, I didn't even realize it's not even all the way there. He's kind of just like a shadow spirit with the floating armor pieces. Let's go ahead and take a listen to the voice pack for this one.
I like the detail in the armor, but it looks a lot like a diamond skin.
I am the Abyss's true champion. It's true, Warden.
It's yeah, like
that's
that.
Scary.
I like that a lot.
Scary.
No, I need to see him in game. I need to see this Kraken.
I know, right? Let's go ahead and show it off in game. Show off some of the abilities and the effects.
Yeah, that Wraithy coloration you were talking about.
I'm gonna have nightmares. Okay,
yeah, I like it.
Yeah.
Creepy. I like the look. It's really small. Right,
that effect.
I know, right? Gosh, the entire effects team killed it. And of course, we got the Kraken.
Oh my God.
I like the colors. The colors look good. Black abilities are not super common. I feel like that looks really good.
And all his glory. Yeah, that is sick. Yeah, Mello's like, nope. Yo, he's got the tusks.
Yeah,
he's got the eyes. Oh my goodness.
And I didn't even know that
range. That's a crazy detail, Dad, because you're never going to notice that shit. This is
fantastic.
Yeah, I am not looking forward to fighting against that in the mid lane. That's nuts.
Yo, just turn that into Cthulhu skin. Like, what? Yeah. Oh my God.
Yeah, that is sick. That is Sunken Sorcerer Poseidon. Headed you guys as well. On November 17th, so a couple weeks after the TMNT patch drops, we got Sunken Sorcerer Poseidon. We're going to move right along, and let's talk about Techno Titan Hercules going to be coming your way in the Odyssey Reckoning. In this one, he's got the armory, kind of cyborg vibes going here. What do you think, Clumsy?
Yo, I like this. We have a lot of different themes with Hercules, but this one's really cool. I'm trying to figure out if he's definitely some sort of hero in this, right? He's smacking down what looks like little mini Jormungandr mechs going on.
Yeah, that's what it looks like. He's got the armor ready, and I believe as we go in game, we'll see a little bit of a closer look at some of the armor that's going on.
Ooh,
I'm loving the hammer there.
Okay, his face kind of ugly.
The weapon looks sick.
But the weapon looks dope, but his face kind of ugly.
I remember seeing the concept for this and going like, huh? But it came out for real.
Yeah, this one turned out amazing. Let's go ahead and take a listen to the voice pack for Techno Titan Hercules.
Systems at maximum. Let's rip our enemies apart.
There we go. Definitely ready to save the day with Techno Titan Hercules, our last skin for the Odyssey Reckoning that's headed your way on November 17th. It's Raven King Chernabog. And this one's definitely got some dark and edgy vibes. I believe this is like a black and red, one of my favorites as we get in. He's got the Plague Master mask coming in. Mel, what do you think about this one?
Bro, I don't like the hands that creep me out, man. Something about like chicken feet.
Mel is like, I just love turtles. I mean, it looks dope. All the creepy stuff, I'm not with it.
I'm kidding. He looks dope as hell, but creepy hands like that with the scales, they do something to me, man. I'm not with it. He's dope though.
Fires out shards. He's gonna be all evil, like.
I just want him to touch me. Right? That's all.
Oh, there we go. And look at the wings. Got the effect going on.
Look at the
on.
Color. Yo, looks of like the he's skin. Got like an like chest diamond, too. Like, diamond yeah, alien skin. Yeah, fire too. What the fuck? You see his rib cage?
I know, right? Let's go ahead and take a listen back. To the voice.
Okay, that's pretty cool.
For Raven
King. I don't
give
a fuck about Chernabog, but this is cool skin.
There is work to be done. Dark work. Let's get to it.
Chernabog.
He is definitely ready for the dark work. As we get ready, that wraps up the Odyssey Reckoning content that's coming you guys' way and the second part of the TMNT update. And we've got a treat for you guys. As we get closer to the World Championships, you know, we have our yearly exclusive bundle, the Digital Loot Pack. And we're going to be taking some time to talk about the new Season 7 Digital Loot Pack that's coming you guys' way. Lots of awesome stuff that you guys will be able to pick up in-game. And we'll start it off with Season 7 Cthulhu. You know, in this bundle, we always do kind of our yearly recolor. And, of course, we had to go with Cthulhu. And I'm loving the purple-white, almost an albino vibe. What do you think, Clumsy?
Yeah, I mean, I love seeing all the different types of Cthulhu colorations. The more we get, the better. And this definitely fits right in.
I know, right? As we get ready to take a look at the turnaround video and show off the model just a little bit, I'm definitely liking this color scheme.
Fuck Cthulhu skins, bro. They're so boring. Like, we get it. I like the colors, but we get it.
I
like
this more than the base. And that's hard to say.
This one is thick.
But I mean, all the different recolors right there are so awesome. This one just fits among all the
I know, right? I feel like Cthulhu recolors just hit different. Like, they're all so good.
Yeah.
Cool. All right. Well, no voice pack for this one because, of course, it's going to use the base Cthulhu voice pack. So we'll move right along to our next skin in the Season 7 Digital Loot Pack, Sir Sandington Set. We've got another addition to the Gentleman's Club, ladies and gentlemen. And
my
man is looking handsome and wealthy.
Yo, like, bro, what is this? It's like they're all what is this?
These skins crack me up, bro. These skins crack me up, right? Man. I love them so much.
What is this?
Yo, the man is suited and booted, man. He's ready to go. He's got the swag. No one on the corner has swagger like him. Let's go ahead and take a look at the model and the turnaround, because I got to see the digs in a little bit more detail.
This card art looks so much better than the actual skin. Yeah. But
that is dapper.
It's interesting.
I know, right? I love it, man. I love the top hat. He's got the pinstripe suit going on. Let's take a listen to the voice pack for Sir Sandington Set.
Who do you think runs this illustrious town?
That's amazing. Yeah.
I'm sorry, man.
It's amazing.
Perfect.
I know,
is
right?
Is that a monocle draped over his shoulder? Wait, what
yeah,
is that?
He's got it, man. He's got anything that a gentleman could want or need, he's got it on him. Let's move right along. So, as I was saying earlier, we're getting closer to the World Championships, and in the Digital Loot Pack, we always like to celebrate our reigning World Championship team. So we've got SK Gaming Merlin here in the Season 7 Digital Loot Pack, and this one turned out great. I got to give a call out, like, SK Gaming, they always came with the swag.
They
had the gray
skin?
And pink jerseys on deck. They were
SK always
even ready.
Left. Why they even put an SK skin in the game?
And the style, and I believe the voice pack calls out to just, you know, being seventh seed and coming out on top. This one looks so great. Let's take a look at the model turnaround here. And I believe we're going to go in game and show off
some of the
effects.
Looks like seventh seed and then winning.
And pinks look sick. Let's go ahead and take a listen to the voice pack for SK Gaming Merlin.
I like the colorway. The colorway is fucking
seventh
awesome.
Seed. Time to win worlds.
Worlds. There we go. And I believe Pawn, our trusty driver, is going to be showing us a little bit more of SK Gaming.
These skins are always
in-game.
Just about the fucking
so
voice packs,
get right
bro.
To it and show off
packs.
Some of these abilities.
Just like with all the different SPL in the world skins, we got to work directly with the team. So I was able to come in contact with the SK boys and make sure we got a lot of awesome voice lines for you guys to make sure that, you know, gets the flavor of the team. So I'm super excited to see this Merlin in game.
I know, right? I love how the Arcane just has like a lightning going on with it. Man, this turned out awesome. He's got like the new mechanical drone for the dragon.
Look at that thing!
I know!
Holy crap! That was badass!
Yo, that fire though!
I'll tell you one thing, yeah, Iris really doesn't get any credit for their art and shit that they do in the games. But the art in these games for multiplayer looks so much better than any other game I play.
I like the effect.
The burn effects as well? Yeah.
Okay. Hello, what's up, buddy?
Oh, that's
cool. My goodness.
Oh, yeah, that's dope.
Take my money, y'all.
Yeah. There we go. Well, that is SK Gaming, Merlin. Again, we got to give a shout out to the SK boys. Congratulations, reigning world championship team. Awesome skin to show off your achievement in game in the Season 7 Digital Loot Pack. We've got one more skin in the Season 7 Digital Loot Pack headed your way. We've got Steel Alchemist Scylla up next, and this one's got the steampunk vibes. I'm not a big steampunk fan,
dude,
but
this might be one of my favorite skins in the game.
Really, really great.
Please, you gave me Sir Cat, my favorite skin in the game.
I like steampunk
Scylla's the next best god for this shit.
She's so much fun to play, so I'm really excited to see this one in game.
This card art.
I'm sure once
this card art is so good, so please tell me you can fuck
her up. Her creatures or her monsters.
Those are nuts. They did a good job. Good job, Hi-Rez. I'm proud of you. Look at those.
I rarely get to see the characters
God.
With their full textures because we work on things at kind of like a lower resolution. But
dude,
this
look at the fucking movement of the hair.
Fantastic.
Okay, this skin dumpsters the other Scylla skins. Holy
I'm loving the vibes on the dress too. Just the details and kind of
thank
the steampunk
finally
period. Just some extra accents on that. Let's go ahead and take a listen to this voice pack before we go in game. We're going to show it off.
Good luck finding another gearhead as good as me. Oh, wait, there is none.
And she's modest.
There we go. There we go, of course. For sure. All right, I'm super excited to take a look at some of these effects and abilities. And here we go. Oh, the basics look clean. I love the golds and yellows.
Nice. I love those like mechanical beasts. So see, because you get to see them so often in Scylla's kit, so that makes great use of them.
I need to learn how to play Scylla.
Oh, that's sweet as well.
I love the colors.
That's awesome.
And you get an awesome, because it's a timing element, right? It's going to expire at the end, so the effects show that off perfectly. I love it.
That is genius.
Right. Yeah. Stop barking. Can never be too careful.
There you go. Got the Sentinel.
Game crash.
Well, it looks like we just had just a little bit of a technical issue with Steel Alchemist Scylla, but we got a chance to see most of the abilities. We'll have everything ready for you guys when PTS goes live later this week. But if you guys are wondering how to pick up the Season 7 Digital Loot Pack, it'll be available for direct purchase in-game on November 17th. Or you guys will be able to get a code for the Season 7 Digital Loot Pack if you pre-order the all-new limited edition SWC at-home kits. We've got the World Championships coming up, and of course, we're all going to be celebrating the event from at home with everything that's going on in the world, but we definitely wanted to give you guys a chance to pick up some awesome swag to commemorate the event. So this is a $60 bundle. It's going to have the Digital Loot Pack. It's going to have a hoodie, a Kepri plushie, a Smite pen.
What?
It's going to have a Season 7 poster that's signed by a bunch of the devs on the Titanforge
team. Oh, that's sick. What the fuck?
A welcome card and some codes from some of our other sponsors and discount codes and stuff like that. Pre-orders for those are available right now. So if you guys want to head over to swag.smitegame.com and pick that up, you guys will be able to pre-order. And believe me when I say it, it is limited supply. So if you guys want this bundle,
shit's going
to
sell out. This shit always sells out, dude.
To pick it up. And that wraps it up for the show,
dude,
guys. Mel,
not even working.
Anything before we sign off? Anything to know?
I think there's too many people going to the website right now.
Reserve me one of those Kepri plushies, right? I'm just going to keep them inside for them.
Maybe we'll see.
The only thing I got is
I'm pretty sure the website just crashed.
Thank Hi-Rez specifically for putting this together with Nickelodeon and giving me the little kid inside of me the joy of a lifetime to be able to work on the Turtles, man. It's just kind of a dream come true.
Broken the daytime stream, man.
It can't really be topped.
For sure, and it definitely shows, man. So much love and hard work went into this new crossover. We hope you guys enjoy it. PTS is going to be live on Friday, so keep it locked to Smite Game on all social media.
That's the stream. Have a good afternoon.